How can you compare the performance of the current year with that of prior years, but still have it be a fair apples to apples comparison, even though your current year is a partial year? Well, of course, you can do that if you only focused on the completed month. So let's say we were in the middle of 2018, we just finished October. The way to do a fair comparison, I mean, right now you can see that these numbers are comparing a partial year with the full prior year, which isn't quite apples to apples. What we would like to do really is to just compare the completed months or the year to date. Now, this is the end result we're going for, and we're going to show you not one, but two ways to get that. Keep watching. Hey, my name is Avi Singh. I'm a Microsoft MVP and a best-selling Power BI author. And if you would like to become a Power BI pro, make sure to subscribe and click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. So this question was asked by Sean McDonald from the sunny state of California, and he was joining us in one of our live talk Power BI shows. So again, you've seen the question. We have the data in this case, and we're pretending that right now we're in September 2018. I just wanted to use that so we can kind of show you the scenario a little more accurately. So here again, we have partial data for 2018 and we have full data for 2017 and 2016. And the end result we want is to just compare the completed months. Now, of course, we don't want any, you know, we want all of this to run automatically. If September is the completed month right now, the next month automatically it should pull in the new month, right? So as soon as we have data over here, it should automatically pull in the current year to date. So that's the goal that we're working towards. Now, one note about the calendar, we are using the ultimate calendar, which you can go and find on my channel. Just go on the channel homepage and look under the Learn Power BI playlist. But we have changed one parameter to again pretend that we're back in the future, and we did that to show you kind of the partial year. As promised, we're gonna show you not one, but two solutions to this, and we're gonna build it step by step. At any point of time, you can click the link shown on this video to download this file at the link shown here. So let's get started. Now, first things first, when you think kind of year to date, that language was used when Sean McDonald kind of asked that question, and you might think back to the classic year to date formula, which it looks like this. Let's take a look at this formula really quick. And yep, it's a classic pattern. It's coming up right now. So, you know, calculate sales dates year to date uses one of the inbuilt time intelligence functions, but that is not for this purpose. That one is for giving you cumulative totals across years. So you can see how dates year to date kind of adds this up cumulatively over years and then resets at the beginning of the year and then resets again. And of course, September 2018 in our scenario is a partial year. That's why you're getting a flat line at the end, and there are other methods to solve that. But again, that's not what we hear to solve. We are here to give Sean this result where automatically it knows kind of what the completed month is, and it's going to say, yep, you know, we just completed August, so I'm going to show you data as of August, and I'm going to compare apples to apples. Now, first of all, there was a decision point here. And by the way, Power BI data modeling often comes down to, you know, the assumptions you're going in with and the decisions you make. So the first decision point that I had was how to decide which is the current month. Now, I was tempted to go to my actual data set to say, hey, I have data till August and use that. But I decided not to do that for two very good reasons. For one, in a lot of cases, you can have data for future dates. In fact, at Microsoft, we would have data for future months because there would be some revenue which would be recognized, booked for future months. And again, there can be lots of other scenarios. We have data for future dates, but they're not what you're trying to show right now. And the other reason is that it may not be just one data set. You might have multiple data sets at different varying levels of data. Maybe for one data set, we have data to last week. For another one, we have data to last month. And it all gets really confusing. So I think the right way to do this is to leverage your calendar. So let's come back over here. And what we have is our calendar is the ultimate calendar. Again, you can find it on my channel. Just look for the ultimate calendar playlist and download that. So here, in one of the features for the Ultimate Calendar is the current month offset. Now, the idea is really, really simple. So let's take a look at that. So what it does is, and again, we are pretending here. So we have set up a parameter in here to pretend that the current date is August 30th, 2018. And let's go back to our current month offset. Yep. So what it's going to do is, it's going to say that, yep, that month is the current month, so it's going to mark it as zero, and anything after that it is going to mark it as 1, 2, 3, 4, and of course going back -1, -2, -3. Now this is an extremely powerful concept, lets you do really mind-bogglingly amazing things, and again, watch the Ultimate Calendar playlist on my channel for that. Here, you know, I just figured I would show you on my channel. So all the good stuff is right at the top in this Learn Power BI playlist. There's a tutorial, there's Ultimate Calendar, there's modeling, DAX, and so forth, right? So that's where you can find that at. So we're gonna use the current month offset to tell us that what the current completed month is. Right, so great. So let's build it kind of step by step. So again, what we have right now here is just a simple sales measure, right? So sum of sales amount, and clearly it's not working, right? It's giving us these year-end totals, which is exactly kind of apples and oranges, right? So these are oranges, which are being plugged in over here, and this is our apple, which is a partial year. Now, 2018 was a ballistic year for Adventure Works. They're doing great. You should definitely buy their stock. I would recommend that. But yeah, so this is a complete year versus partial year. So that's what we want to change. Now, what I like to do is to solve DAX issues, is to solve it thinking about like how a human would solve it. And this is the tricky part, because humans are intuitive, so you have to break down that thinking step by minute step, and then all you have to do is just teach those steps to Power BI. It's easy, right? So how would a human calculate it? Well, for one, how would a human know that which is the current month? And again, so we decided that, so again, a human has to know that, oh, it's still August. I have to stop at August. And so we have to determine that. Well, how do we do that? Well, we do that using, as we discussed, the current month offset. So let's go kind of solve that first. So I'm going to write my very first DAX measure, and this is actually one that we're not going to be using, but I just want to kind of start there as a baby step. So let's go to the modeling tab over here, and hold on 1 second. All right, it was just acting up a little bit. So let's do a new measure over here, and we're going to say max month. Again, our goal is to be able to tell the model that 8 August is the maximum month. So we'll go in over here. Perfect, and we'll say max month, and I'll say try one. Oops, try one. And what if we just said max of month num? Right? How would that work? Now I know that wouldn't work, but let's just see what happens with this formula. All right, so max month, and what I'm going to do is I have my special formulas table, and we're going to place it there, and I'm going to place it on this matrix. And you can see that the max month is returning 12. So it's just, you know, so it's just going to each year and saying, oh, well, yeah, my max month is 12. That's not quite what we're looking for. We want the month num where the current month offset is zero. So we just want that one specific result. So let's try this again, and we're going to say new measure max month. So we're going to try the same thing, but we're going to bring out a magic wand, calculate, right? So calculate, and we're going to say same thing, month num. There we go, right? But then this is where the magic wand kind of comes in. You can specify additional filters or functions. And the first function we're going to use is all, because we want to clear the calendar filter. Even if you're under 2016 or 17, we don't want to consider that. We want to clear all filters on calendar. So that's the first thing that we do, all calendar year, and then we're going to zoom in again, right? So we're going to zoom out all calendar, and then we're going to zoom in again to the calendar current month offset is zero. So let's say current month offset, perfect, equals zero, and that's it. Now you can try it without the all and see how it would work. Okay, I didn't need that. And let's see the result of this. So again, bingo. So 8 August, so it goes to the most recent, you know, it goes to the current month offset again based on our ultimate calendar table and picks out the month num for that. So now we have the month num. Now all we have to tell Power BI is to, you know, you have the month num, right, buddy? Go ahead and when you're calculating the sales, only calculate with a month num up to that month num, right? So where a month is less than or equal to that maximum. Simple, right? So again, break down how a human would solve it kind of step by step, and then we're teaching it Power BI in a step by step as well. So we have ignore the maximum, try one, but we're gonna focus on the second one, this result, and use that. So I'm gonna say a new measure, and we'll say, let's say sales across prior years. And I'm intentionally not using the year-to-date language because it has a very different connotation in Power BI generally, and it has the built-in year-to-date function. So I'm just saying sales across prior years. I mean, if you want, you can use the year-to-date function, right? So again, so we're gonna say calculate. So actually, I changed my mind. We're gonna start by getting the value of the max month. So we're gonna define a variable max month and just reference the max month measure we're doing. And just as a test, I often like to just return something really quick and just to see that it's working. Now, of course, it is. I expect it to work, but you know, I like kind of steps where we say, okay, it's already there. So you can see that it's returning the same result. So it's not quite sales yet, but we're really, really close to it. So get into action here, and let's see if we can solve this problem. So again, so now I'm gonna bring out my magic wand, calculate, and again, the logic is simple. I've already taught the human. I broke it down like what the steps the human would take, and I'm teaching Power BI the same steps. And so, hey, calculate sales, and the only thing you have to remember is not to go beyond the max month. Only go to the max month, and I've already figured out what the max month is. So that one becomes so easy. So we say calendar month num is less than equal to max month. And that should do it, my friends. Let's check the results. Sales across prior years. It's calculating. Looks great. Let's put some formatting in here. We're going to make it shine a little bit. So currency, zero. And yeah, I'll let you do the math. But yeah, if you were to add up January through August, this would add up to exactly 4.413 million, and same thing for 2017. Now, a few things here. Now, so again, this is just solution one. Wait till you see the second solution, and then you can decide which one is easier, which one you would prefer. A few things here. For one, did you realize that if I hadn't used the variable that it wouldn't work? Do you know what error we would get? If you do know that why a variable is used and why not using a variable would not work, drop in a comment and let me know. Or go ahead and give it a try and let me know what happened, right? So that part is important. Now the next thing is that I like building step-by-step Lego block as in Lego block. You don't necessarily need the max month to be a separate variable. In fact, we can define a new version of this, so we can copy the same measure, go over here, new measure, and let's say V2, and instead of having to define that in a separate variable, what we can do is, I'm going to copy that formula from my other sheet, and just put that in, right? So you saw what we did. Instead of building it kind of in two variables, we can choose to do it in a single variable. That's totally up to you. And they both, of course, would give you the same result. But this was the solution one, which was kind of a DAX approach of doing it. There is a totally different way to solve it using leveraging the query editor and adding on to our ultimate calendar table, and that's why it is called the ultimate calendar table, because not only is it chock full of goodies, but it's really easy to customize. So for this challenge, I wanted to take another shot at it, and let me just give you kind of the final solution, show you what it looks like. So here, in the alternate solution, what we have is we have a flag in our table which marks what is year to date. So let me clear this flag for a second. So you can see, and again, this is being done in the query editor. And what I'll let you do is that I'll let you download the file from this link, and that way you can examine exactly how that column is being built. In fact, it is not just that column. I also added a few new things to the ultimate calendar table, which is the not just the year to date flag, but quarter to to date and month to date. So it's going to give you a lot more flexibility. So now, so this measure that I'm using right now is actually my sales measure, if I'm not wrong. Let's go take a look. So this is sales measure, sum of sales, sales amount, right? That's it. That's the extent of DAX on this page. But given the strength of the ultimate calendar table, what do you need to do so that you get the same apples to apples comparison? You need to drag and make a slicer out of that that flag year to date field built into your calendar table. You can just copy paste and use that ultimate calendar, and you're gonna click on this one button. Ta-da! And this is the exact same result we got using the DAX approach. So what do you think, my friends? Which approach is better, or which one would you prefer? And of course, there could be other fun steps that you play with. You can change the measure to only use completed months. So in that, you're gonna use current month offset as -1 instead of 0 that we used. You could change the measure to work at a day level, not just at a month level. So go ahead and try it out. And of course, an easy way to get started on that would be just to download the file and go from there. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.